Hello and welcome to episode 18 of the OEB Let's Play series on Oldbrook V2. Now today, or this episode rather, I said I was going to do some bailing. Turns out I'm going to be doing a lot of bailing. 90 bales was the bale end of the field, the bale counter. That's a lot of bales. It's going to go well into the night. The Massey is ready. I have found out the autoload system on this trailer doesn't work with these bales, it doesn't recognise them, so they are different. Hopefully, it does have a locking script on it, it will lock them. Because obviously we do need that trailer for the wool pallets, and the other one is rather expensive. Should come under baling. Yeah, it's 58,000. You also notice we're rather poor to what we should be. This should be well within our grasp. I have to admit, I did a little bit of spending. Anita Rose, so group 2, fourth one, we have a new toy. John Deere 6210R. It's a nice looking mod actually, I'm impressed. I forgot how nice this one was. It's got the BGR camera. I'm not sure if it's actually made by BGR. Too far, Oh, it said they've all been recent releases by Dural. It doesn't actually say. Dural's converted them all to MR, done his version of the conversion. The New Holland, the John Deere pack and the case. All recent releases on FSUK. I mean, this is a nice tractor on its own. I've not played so much of the New Holland, but I've been using this particular John Deere for a while. Well, I have been doing my single player games. Join the team, it's not quite got the ponies when need on the server. But yeah, lovely looking model. Better put him back to where the camera, you see, it sort of like appears that it looks over the shoulder. There, you can just see it's that taking over now. Easy to see the rear hitch. And when you use IC control, open the window, it looks even further out. How cool is that? I am a fan of this system. Wrong one, come on. I see. Every time that catches me up, every time. Right then, everybody is currently working. So, you're in this field. You're starting our seeding. We're just getting around to seeding now. But rather than cheat this time, I've played it fairly. I have power harrowed everything. Not gone for the plough this time though. After the last time, we don't need it just yet. We only have barley in there, so a bit of stubble. We do use the power harrow, so they do kick out a bit more than a normal cultivator as well. Massey, you're waiting patiently for me to get the telehandler down. You're gonna go sell us some pigs. You are on your way down. Are you actually down now? No, you're just going past the pig farm. There's the lighthouse, pig farm's on the left. As you can see, on the PDA he's not even attempted to fall yet. I'll leave that off just in case we get the red message. Game over. And the other one, new toy, group 4. I went and bought the Scania. Upgraded from the Merc. I think it's about 500 ponies, this one's a 730 V8. She's a bit of an animal. But probably the best thing about this mod is the interior. Look at that. I believe it's pulled straight out of a Euro Truck Simulator model. But absolutely fantastic. I think this is quite possibly the best interior on a Scania in the game. Sounds nice too. She really does sound like a monster. Don't know if they're official sounds, but I like them. I'm a fan. I did do a little bit of rounding up our manure. Well, as you can see, that's building up again. I've not done the liquid manure yet. I'm not actually sure if the cross out's full or empty. It may be empty now. I have to do a bit of work around the fields. Sprint over and have a little look. We're going to put the truck to work. Yeah, that's pretty empty. Okay then. Actually, no, not just yet, because you need to get to work, my friend. He has completely emptied Bunker 4. Obviously, apart from the plane, I haven't made disappear back underground yet. So that one is done. And we have a lot of liquid manure. We have a full crossout in either one at the moment. The juice is slipping. He didn't quite make it. Oh dear. Hopefully he's not disappeared off the map. The issue with the fall when it goes wrong. This is strange because he hasn't made it on previous attempts. Oh well. Bunker 4, no, you need to go in Bunker 2 now. BGA 1, yes. Obviously with this course you can't start from anywhere but the beginning. So make sure he's at the beginning. Unleash him. What happened? You were so close. At least you made it around the corner, you're not disappeared off the map. I think I have an idea what happened. You need to slow down. No, no, he had it under control. Four-wheel steering, it's a bit of a killer. He seemed to steer quite well in the end. Oh well, as long as he gets there, actually. Where are you? Just can't make it out. Yeah, bottom of field 6. Stop you there, unlock. You need to go to the shop to pick up your new toys that we've actually had there for a while now. It's the bale handler. Off the hedge. Just to make sure it does come down here, I'll have a look as well. I believe it loops around the bottom of field 6, not seeing anything. There we go. Here's one I did earlier. Stop being crazy, slow down a bit. No rush, we'll get there in the end. Piggies. No. Stop you. Zoom out. Where are we going? Over there, look. Turn the four-wheel drive on for a bit of traction around the yard. Obviously had a power harrow on, that's why he's got maximum weight on the front. Still don't have any IC of anything on this track, so you can't select it. I'll get there in the end. But with all the fast forwarding I've been doing, we actually have quite a lot of pigs. Over 300. A trailer that only carries 30. Obviously we have plenty of vehicles now to do our work. All we're going to need is a massive running the bale trailer. Everything's, depends on if the JD's finished. Everything's been cultivated, so we're only just running the seeder then. So a bit of downtime. And the John Deere is actually the lowest powered tractor I have at the moment. At 210, you can tell the difference as well. I think the fast track was cultivating 7.5 mile an hour, the John Deere's between 4 and 5 depending. Yeah, that seems to be a bit quicker. So pig. There we go. not sure if I mentioned, but I have edited the steering axle on the trailer. You can actually see it at work now. So we park just here. It should become quite apparent, hopefully. You can just see it moving a little bit back there. Either way, he now makes it through the gate. Good stuff. Right, that's you to work. You. Come here. And you can see everyone's got the lights on cosplay now. It's getting dark. Yes, this is the new bale handler. Don't think it has a locking script. No. You should either get it right or you get it wrong. But yeah, pretty cool. I like. Should be plenty of space for us to double stack them as well. Should be. In the interest of I don't suppose it matters where you put this one, it's gonna spike something. Is that going to be the best option for us? Probably. Neither one of them is really great to travel around with. Spikes either way. Normally you travel with the spikes down, but obviously then you're pointing them forwards. Health and safety out the window on this trip. Shop. To farm. And then we can meet. I think I'm only going to do maybe one full trail on camera. It's going to take long enough. I didn't manage to get field 21 seeded either. I was a little bit busy. If I'd have brought the John Deere sooner than what I did, we'd have got away with it. But obviously we were trying to hit the great demand. Come on. Cutting it fine already with 21 hours left. I've still got a field full of 90 bales before I can get in there to slurry it, cultivate it and seed it. It's going to be a bit of a mad rush when we get the bales out, I think. Obviously the seeder can only seed one seed field at a time. So he's happily in the other two for now. Gives us a bit of breathing space. We may yet go up and do field 21. I wonder if it'd be wise doing that in barley actually. Really hit this great demand. Might be a good idea. Have some serious acreage. We have the I haven't edited the cutter trailer yet either, or header trailer. I'm gonna need to sort that out before we go up top. I suppose it does work as it is at the moment, it's just I like things to be right and it's not quite right just yet. And he's already started on his tractor sides. Looking good. Right, we'll knock that off so we know what everyone else is doing. Stop you. Knock that off. And here we go. Reset the cars, we don't want those on anymore. I thought it's going to be fun. Right then. This is where having a steering wheel becomes wonderful. There we go. A nice spike. We have one bale. Maybe start them three high actually. Yeah? Assuming the telehandler can handle it. Let's have a go. I don't actually have a joystick to operate the loader arms, I'm using my mouse. But it seems to work fine. That's two, should be able to get three on here. click on one of these over here. It doesn't really matter which bales we grab first, we need to get them all eventually. Just not quite low enough. As you can see, the MR bales so don't go flying like the other ones. There we go. They're a lot stickier than what they used to be. They actually behave like proper bales, so you can get away doing this. Assuming the AgriVector can handle the weight. Even when we turn the corner. No, not moving at all. Good, good. Obviously if you drive forward at a crazy speed now and hit the brakes, they will fly. Is it possibly up to a ton per bale? You give a ton some momentum, it's not going to stop instantly. It needs to coast to a gentle stop, ideally. I don't know if it would be a ton of bale. 3 ton on the front of the telehandler is possibly a lot. Have I got this about right? I was close. That's as close as I'm going to get. No, let go. The collisions on the bales just not quite behaving as I'd like them to. Now, can we get out this time? That's better, but it's not on a very good angle now. We should be able to push it back from the other side when we get a chance. Is that one actually under the trailer? It's close. Right then, so looking at this, it is pretty much in the middle where you have to attack these bales. Properly in the middle, you can't even go at an edge. Yeah, that seems to be the accessible point. It makes sense, I mean in the middle, obviously that's where you try and grab it in real life, keep the balance on that. They have collisions. Maybe the load arounds moved a bit quick there. In the middle seems to be where the best place to grab the VA back up. Here's where the four wheel steering really helps. Gutted. I'm not going to pull him back from underneath now, am I? Right then. Damn, you did a little bit of work, my friend. Have you stopped?
Yes.
It's not quite perfect. It's nowhere near. I can do better. Obviously, the better the stacking, the more we can get on the trailer. I wonder if we can shake them about on the bale handler and reset them. Better. I can take that. Anybody who's ever driven a telehandler before? Great view. Can't see anything to your right feet. I am stuck behind the bales. These are so much fun to drive. The depth perception is not amazing in this game. I'm going to keep it in the outside view, just to make my life easier. I have to drive one of these in real life, it's hard enough then. I was actually in it the other day, the load and shove was playing up again and we had to have the fitter out to it. And the telehandler we're using at the minute, she has seen better days. She's not 100%, bless her. And we're stuck on the headboard. Perfect. Far from it. Come on. Oh, now you've been silly. Come on, let go. Aha, there we go. Six on anything in the corner, no. Too low. Fast track is back up there. So I damaged six bales in the time it took him to go sell a full load of pigs. Wow. This is where it would be really handy to have a sideways shuttle. That's no good, not when we get them on the trailer. I sent it the other way now, I have, haven't I? Yeah, close enough, it'll do. Looking like it's our bale. It would be if I never shot it. There we go. The trailer, we're going to get 1, 2, 3, 4 stacks of 24 bales on then. That's not too bad. Assuming I can stack them right. Oh dear. I don't know if anybody has to start a jump then. No. Here we go. Like, the DPI in my mouse might be a bit high here. That's better. Yeah, that's lower. Not good for camera viewing, but it'll do for this. Moving one up. So we get on there. Right, more bales. Let's move the fast track along. Still behind an angle here, so I'll try and be nice to them. The fast track's probably going to be better in the middle of the field, actually. Right, is key Z supposed to attach the load, release the load? Attach, release. So in theory, that's got them. Don't appear to be moving, so I'm going to have to agree. Let's test it. Oh, I think we're good. I read. Right, release them then. Turn you off, because we don't need you running for this. Nothing else quite down here, so we'll move on up there. Oh, better go to the fast track out first, hadn't we? Keep the money coming in. The John Deere is actually the most expensive tractor I've bought as well. Why didn't he sell? He didn't sell the pigs, did he? Oh dear. Well, that's going to be annoying. Stop at the last point or at next trigger. Yes. Why aren't you selling? That's no fun. So we must have made another 10,000 from somewhere else. BGA perhaps? Is the milk gone? No, I'm still there. Very curious. I don't believe there is a opening hours set into the pig sale. This again. That looks better. Seems to be the way I'm lining everything up too far to the right. Oh well. This episode's not going to be much talking, I'm afraid. My focus is going to have to be on this part. Multitasking is not my strong point. Multitasking, remembering things. I am useless at remembering things. If the wife doesn't remind me, it will be forgotten. Hopefully she's not going to forget to remind me about her birthday due soon. Because it won't end well for me. But I already can't remember the date. There we go, it's coming along nicely. I think when we get to the end of it, I may have to use a bale to squash them all up. Hopefully it's not going to catapult them everywhere. Shouldn't do, but it'll be interesting to know. I might as well be the guinea pig. Again, too far to the right. I wonder. No, I still can't see. It's behind the headlight and behind the corner post. For this job, having a steering wheel is definitely 1,000 times better than the keyboard. And he's hanging over again, is that acceptable? Yeah, it'll do. Interesting to know if this bale trailer releases the bales in the bale trigger as well and lets them sell. So obviously I've got the mixing station, so I've no use of the bales. You never know, I may keep the last trailer just to show a little bit about the mixing station, how it works with bales. I think the one at the sheep farm does actually need a straw. Not bad. Ooh, missed it. Try again. Are you gonna behave? It's not going to flick on, are you? There we go, got it. Kind of. Oh dear. See if I can't flick it back on when it's on top of this one. Way over to the side, oh dear. Not got it flush. Oh, the one below is off centre now. this is not going to go so well, I don't think. This stack of three is going to be a problem. Not too bad, we've had worse. Just to pull the times out of that one before we can go into this one. God love the MR bales. Actually behaving like bales. Mostly. go a little bit higher. Now I wonder if we couldn't actually get another stack on the end of this if we squashed them all up. I'm going to have a go. I'll get those straight, then I'll pull the massive forward again. I'm working a clockwise sort of loop, I think. Quite well. Possibly spoke too soon, still got one to go. No, that's not too bad. Clear the alignments off. There we go. Now why won't you pick up? That's strange, because we weren't quite in the middle. Oh, we've been nitpicking. Well, there's either three more to go on this then. Why is that fast track not showing up again? For some reason he's not picking up the trigger. Well, that's annoying. Chance of turning this round on the climb, slim, very slim. There's a bail there, so we can't do anything crazy. Now this was working with a different wave. I think it actually worked with fast track last time, so why is it not working now? I wonder if there is a time scale then on the pitch cell. That's quite frustrating if there is. It's our own map, but I don't actually know that. It's just strange why he's not selling. Send him back down there again. I'll sort these bales out, hopefully. By the time I get back, keep my eye on him. 20 disappears up past the garden centre, we're going to have to follow him. So I'm actually curious as to whether there is a timer on it. I think I've heard of it in some maps. It may be in all of them. Obviously I must sell to the Great Demands. So when a Great Demand's on, I presume it would overwrite any such script. Easy. Just to make sure they're not going to jump. was just slightly over to the right again. See, that's actually gone a little bit higher. Midway. So they're not quite perfect, but it is a good little system. I like it. I like the fact that the pack comes with the bale handler as well. Oh, just a shame I don't have enough money to play with that trailer. It looks kind of cool. I believe the sides operate on it to hold them all in rather than having a proper locking script like the Agrius Tenius one here. It's physically held in by the sides. It's another different approach. Got him. And you can see the fast track is just disappearing up past the garden centre now. But we're going to have to go and supervise him to find out what's happening. Just enough time to get these bales on. Remove the whole stack or just the one in the middle? The whole stack. Okay then, we'll leave that there. Right, fast track. What are you playing about at? We can see the cars. We can see that he should sell. Oh, idiot. That's why he's not selling. My fault. Transfer, so he was just transferring, just driving the trailer for the sake of driving the trailer. There we go, now we're selling. Oh dear. Wonder if anybody watching actually spotted that before I realised. If you didn't, welcome to my world. If you did, well done. The amount of times I've spotted little things on Cosplayer from people actually playing with and not being able to tell them what's going on. And I make similar sort of mistakes myself. It's different when you're actually playing though to watching. You seem to see more when you're watching. Different perspective and such like. I wonder if this will actually go on then. Ooh, that was close. Right, nothing that's up here, that one there, so we'll take him. Oh, wow. That was bad. No, reverse. Right then, let's test this little theory out. Right, 6, 12, 18, 24 bells on there at the moment then. Not a bad dint out of the 90 in the field. 4 trailers, I think we should have it. But if we can get on another 3, I'm very happy. So let's see if it can be done. answer is a resounding yes. Oh, there we go. How's that then? That's pretty good. I'm quite impressed with that. That is full use of the trailer. Up against the headboard, just a little bit at the end. I'm gonna have to take a screenshot of that. I like that. I'll be saving that picture. The best way to take screenshots with this is gonna be from inside the Massey, I think. So use HUD hider. Now to hide load status. Ooh, the fence gonna cause me a little problem. He's just done this with HUD hider hides the HUD of cosplay, but not the finish message. Suppose it has its bonuses. Well, there we go. Right, to hide load status, hold Alt. There we go. One screenshot. Attach the load. Hopefully they all stay attached. Yeah, seems like quite a good locking script. Ooh, I wonder. Should I experiment with the slings or not? No, I don't think I will. Just in case. Just maybe that bell seems to be falling off. I wonder if it's only locking the ones on the bottom. Such as for the wool pallets or something. Will the bale sell? Yes. 57,000, 58,000. Not bad. £1,000 for 6 bales. I think that's definitely giving more money than the foraging. Time are we on? 48. Yes, I need to put the fence into the next field. That's assuming how the John Deere's getting on anyway. He is right over on the left hand side of field 9, so he has not got much further to go. Out of 2,000 seeds then, taken from the seed bins, we've only ended up with 165 litres remaining. 2,000 litres of seeds, 2,000 seeds. So yeah, that's a lot of barley seed for this field. I may or may not have to up the capacity in the seed bins. So obviously I'm only using these three fields. If you're using the full map, so to speak, well, I think for our arable team, they had, just on the screen there, where are you? We'll go over here, right? The arable farm itself was running field 10, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 22, 6, 9, 8, and 7. Dairy, so they've got all those fields just out of those seed bins. It's definitely going to need to be bigger. Dairy was running these, I think arable had those as well. Obviously the pig farm was only running those three, but you had the pigs and the BGA. And the allotment as well, we've not got any greenhouses on the go yet. Yeah, the seed bins are definitely going to need to be bigger. Yeah, pop it over the seeder. Select seeds. We want barley seed. Start filling, fill her right up again because we're only going to fill four to do her once we get the bales out of there and get it prepared. There we go. I took the collision off on the pipe as well just in case. Saves anything becoming annoying, shall we say. So the arms of the seeder get caught in it, the roof of the tractor would get caught in it. happened to get the angle that I was looking for, it was easy just to not have it collidable. Obviously when the mod's released, if anybody wants to change it back, it's a simple enough process. Where are we? Field 9 then. 9 metres. First waypoint. Lovely ground texture. Colourated texture looks really smart on this. So I was playing about revving the tractor there. Little things. You back where you are. Yes you are. Good. Let's have another load of piggies in. Now we know what I screwed up. Better way of figuring this out. Are you going to clip that gate now? No, you're in there. You missed the fences. I'm going to deserve a medal for that bit. These fences are collidable as well. That was the best reversing I've done in a long time. Can't lend credit for it, it was all the fast track. What a lovely mod that's turned out to be. Right, away we are. Here we are, power wheel drive, not the slip down. You're looking good. You're powering through. That other one's still digesting away. I can see the second roller again now though. Yeah, over there. 165,000 litres, 20%. That's more than what the crossout can hold. I think that's actually enough to fertilise all the fields. 171, yeah, we are well underway. Good stuff. Very, very good. How's our great demand looking now? 20 hours. It's going to take roughly 24 to pull. Well, before the crop's ready, then we have to harvest it. I really hope it's a nice long great demand this time. I think it was 5 hours, the last barley one. It's just not long enough. At least it was two. We have, there you go, 200,000 litres still in the silos. So we're good. We've got something to throw at it, even if the fields aren't ready. Right then, I'll crack on with the baling and I shall be back in daylight, hopefully all the fields ready to go and a great demand ticking away with plenty of time. So yeah, thanks for watching episode 18. I'll catch you on episode 19. Catch you later, bye.